plans on the table. They will affect anyone with a 401k retirement account, which covers just about all of us, at least all of those of us who are working. Joining me now from Chicago is Austin Goolsbee. He's Senator Obama's chief economic advisor. And from Arlington, Virginia, Douglas Holtz Eakin, senior economic advisor to the McCain campaign. Gentlemen, good to have you both on. Austin, let's start with you. Part of Senator Obama's plan would eliminate the penalty on withdrawals of up to 15% of a person's 401k, up to a maximum of $10,000. The McCain campaign says that that would see a flight of capital from the market potentially. What do you say?
Well, it was unbelievable that the McCain people said that and then three sentences later proposed something that would lead to a vastly larger flight of capital from the market. Senator Obama recognized that we are in a hardship situation, and just as the law now allows very specific hardship exemptions for withdrawing without a penalty, it's clear that this is a much broader problem, and so we ought to have a temporary solution of that form.
Doug, what about what Austin just said? And he's talking about having the capital gains tax on investments that people have held for more than a year over the next 2 years. Some analysts say that could lead to a flight of capital from the market.
Well, the provision is for next year, 2009, and the year after, so it's an incentive for investors to hold. There's a requirement that you have a holding period of at least 1 year to get this reduced rate. This is an attempt to build some confidence in markets, get investors in, and restore the value of assets that are held by pension funds all across America, in addition to the IRAs and 401ks.
Yeah, but would that just be a temporary fix, though, because people wanted to take advantage of that reduction in capital gains? You would think logically they would want to cash in some of those investments.
Well, I think the point at which it becomes a pressure to cash in becomes toward the end of 2010, where we're facing a large tax increase, and so there'll be pressure on the Democrats in Congress to not have that tax increase and keep people in the market.
Austin, let's talk about another big problem that people face, and that's holding on to their homes. Senator Obama's proposed a 90-day moratorium on foreclosures, but critics complain that without additional measures to help people refinance their mortgages, that what you're really doing is you're just kicking the can down the road, you're just prolonging the problem.
Well, no, I don't agree. It wasn't a blanket 90-day freeze on foreclosures. This is as a reciprocity condition for lenders that receive billions of dollars of handout from the government as part of the rescue. They would agree that for people living in their homes, so no speculators, and for people making good faith attempt to make the payments on their mortgages, these are people that are likely going to qualify for a restructuring program through the government, and so it doesn't make any sense for the lenders to be able to go down and throw them out of their homes quickly before the people would qualify for a restructuring.
And Doug, what about Senator McCain's plan to help people stay in their homes through mortgage purchases? People say that a part of the problem with it is that you would spend some of that $300 billion or a large part of it buying up mortgages at face value that weren't worth as much as you were paying. What sense does that make?
Well, I mean, the only way to have a lender not get face value is to have people default. And we have 10 million mortgages underwater, one out of six mortgages in America. We have another 3 million or so who are distressed, delinquent. And this is a big problem. And to simply do the kinds of things that Senator Obama has suggested is too little too late, quite frankly. All the estimates are you'll get 400,000 or 500,000 people from those measures. This is the fundamental problem facing the U.S. economy. We need dramatic action to shore up housing values for every American homeowner. And this is an approach that can do that and do it quickly. And so Senator McCain thinks we ought to solve the big problem, and it'll stabilize the banking system at the same time.
Obviously, going to be a lot of talk about this tonight at the debate at Hofstra. Doug, I know that you're going up. Austin, you'll be holding down the fort there in Chicago. So maybe we'll get back with you tomorrow morning. We'll find out how it all went. Doug Holtz Eakin and Austin Goolsbee, always good to talk to you. Thanks so much.
Great to see you.
All right, bye-bye. If you've got any questions, by the way, for the campaigns about